Hi everyone, here is English for All, and we have prepared two video presentations about New Zealand and one in grammar about nouns. You will learn some cultural aspects and places you may visit in New Zealand, which is really far but very beautiful for tourists. And in grammar, we'll talk with you about nouns, how to build their forms, and how to make a positive way to speak about containers. So, you see, we have a lot of work to do. Don't waste your time, don't click your channel, and let's get started. In this video episode, I'm going to talk with you about different aspects connected with culture. You remember we talked with you about the United States, the United Kingdom, Australia. And today I want to talk with you about one English-speaking country that is very far but really beautiful. This country is called New Zealand. In the presentation you will see some facts about sightseeing and which places tourists may visit if you are in New Zealand. So, wish you good luck and be attentive. Hi everyone! In this video program, we are going to talk with you about what to do in New Zealand. Which activities attract many tourists to this far country? So let's take a look. New Zealand is an island, it's in southwestern Pacific Ocean, and it consists of two main land masses, the North Island and the South Island, and more than 700 smaller islands, covering a total area of 268,000 square kilometers. Here, in the next video slide, you can see the fact file. Let's take a look at some interesting facts about New Zealand. New Zealand is one of the last major land masses settled by humans. Elizabeth II is the Queen of New Zealand, and thus the head of state. New Zealand has an advanced market economy, ranked 14th in 2019 Human Development Index and 3rd in 2020 Index of Economic Freedom. English is a predominant language in New Zealand, spoken by 95.4% of the population. Stewart Island is the third largest island of New Zealand and is found even further south than South Island. Most of the island is forested and undeveloped, with over 80% of the island being set aside as a Rekura National Park, giving you the chance to explore the wild side of New Zealand. Glacier Country is found on the western coast of South Island, and its jewel is the Westland National Park. In the park, you'll have the chance to see the country's two most spectacular glaciers, Franz Josef Glacier and Fox Glacier. Hobbiton. If you're a fan of Tolkien's Lord of the Rings and Hobbit, you'll definitely want to take a day trip from Auckland to the home of Middle-earth at Hobbiton movie set. More than 150 locations in New Zealand were used to film the two movie series, but a significant number were filmed at Hobbiton movie set on a family farm near Hamilton. One of the most scenic spots in New Zealand is the Fiordland National Park. Here you can set off an incredible hikes, fish for trout or cruise on the spectacular fjords named Sounds here in the southwestern corner of the South Island. Milford Sound is the biggest attraction in Fiordland, and it is true fjord created by a glacier. At the top of the South Island is Nelson, a spot known for having the greatest number of sunshine hours per year in all of New Zealand. This great climate and the fact that the city is surrounded by three national parks makes Nelson a fantastic spot for outdoor recreation.So here we go. The seaside resort of Napier on North Island is known as the Art Deco capital of New Zealand, thanks to a large amount of 1930s architecture built when the city suffered a large fire more than 80 years ago.Rotorua is a city on the southern shores of Lake Rotorua, from which the city takes its name, located in the Bay of Plenty region of New Zealand's North Island. If you are interested in exploring the Bay of Islands,The Pier is a great place to visit in New Zealand. Pier is all about a small town feel, but it boasts an array of great hotels and recreational opportunities to appeal to travelers. Auckland.Is a large metropolitan city in North Island of New Zealand. The most populous urban area in the country, Auckland has an urban population of about 1,470,000 people. The town is built around an inlet called Queenstown Bay on Lake Wakatipu, a long thin Z-shaped lake formed by glacier processes, and has views of nearby mountains such as the remarkable Cecil Park, Walter Peak, and just above the town Ben Lomond and Queenstown Hill.Tongariro National Park is the oldest national park in New Zealand, located in the central North Island. It has been acknowledged by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site of mixed cultural and natural values. Tongariro National Park was the sixth national park established in the world.New Plymouth is a major city of Taranaki region on the west coast of North Island of New Zealand. It is named after the English city of Plymouth, Devon, from where the first English settlers to New Plymouth migrated.Wellington. Delightfully located on a harbor with mountains surrounding it,Wellington is the scenic capital of the country and certainly lives up to its nickname as a windy city. Lovely wooden buildings pour down the mountain slide to the waterfront, and there is a fantastic arts and culture scene for visitors to enjoy, with great museums, galleries, and theaters to offer.That was a video presentation, What You Can Do in New Zealand. In this video presentation, I'm going to talk with you about grammar. You know, we talked with you about adjectives, adverbs, and today it's high time to talk about nouns. How we construct nouns and why we use nouns, how we can make different expressions with nouns. Today we will talk with you about containers, how to connect them and make your speech more beautiful. So be attentive and watch the following video presentation. In this video, it's time to talk about nouns. We'll talk with you about singular forms and plural forms. Let's start with containers and quantities. With uncountable nouns, we use different containers. For example, we use a container first, then we add of, and we name a product. A cup of tea. A bar of chocolate. Look at this picture and name a container. It's a jar. And this one is a bottle. And this one is a cup. Chocolate bar, or we can say a bar of chocolate. A carton of milk. A jug. Now you have to translate from Ukrainian into English. A jar of honey. A bottle of oil. A cup of tea. A bar of chocolate. Now you look at the pictures and name containers and products. This is a cup of coffee. And it's a bar of chocolate. It's a can of corn. And that's a carton of juice. A jar of honey.
Let's speak about the results we have achieved today. Today we talked with you about different aspects of culture, including New Zealand, places to visit, and grammar, how to speak about nouns and different containers. So you see, we've done a lot of work, and I hope our next video class will be fruitful and essential for you. So I wish you a good day, take care, keep studying English, and goodbye.